Hey, what's up, guys? This is Dark Arm Duels, and today I'm going to be doing a guest upload. I know it's the first time I've ever done one, so you guys are going to be viewing me on Team FTK's channel, which is really, really cool. He's an awesome YouTuber that's been doing this a little while. He has about 1,500 subscribers, and you guys can totally view that below because you guys are a part of his channel by watching this video. I can't encourage you enough to subscribe to his channel and mine. His channel is really, really awesome. I love his channel a lot. I've been working with him for the last couple of months. He's a great guy, great YouTuber. We've been helping each other out, and he just has a great channel. You guys should totally subscribe to him and definitely hit that bell in there for him. And this video is going to be my gift to him for our first guest upload. He did a guest upload on my channel not too long ago, which the video will be down in the comments down below or down in the description down below. You guys should totally check out that video. It was a Yusinju deck profile on my channel, Dark Arm Duelist. And without further ado, guys, let's get straight on this. This one's for you, Team FTK. I hope I do you justice. So let's get straight on into this. So this is probably one of my favorite decks. He actually encouraged me to play one of my favorite decks of all time for his channel because he gave me one of his favorite decks of all time. My favorite deck of all time is actually Black Wings, but I just updated that one not too long ago, so I did my second favorite deck profile of all time besides Red Eyes Black Dragon, and that is Crusadia's. I absolutely love how well this deck OTKs my opponent, with how simple it is and how cheap just the pure version is. I am playing the pure version of Crusadia with a couple of extra spicy techs that I play, and I absolutely love these with orange sleeves. They just look crazy cool. So first off, we're going to be playing three copies of Crusadia Maximus. I absolutely love his name. These actually play in with the World Legacy lore, which is really nice. This card's effect is that you can special summon this from your hand in defense position to a zone a Link monster points to. They all have that effect. All your Crusadia main deck monsters have the effect, and then they give boost effects to each one of your Crusadia XYZ or Link monsters. This one gives the effect that it doubles the damage your opponent takes from battles involving the Link monster that this card is pointing to. So for instance, if I have Crusadia Maximus here, and I have Crusadia Equalmax here, the damage that Equalmax does to you is going to be doubled, which is really, really, really cool. I absolutely love my Equalmax. He's just such a good card. Then we play three copies of Crusadia Leonidas. Leonis is just such a good card. With the effect of that you can target one Crusadia Link monster you control, and if it attacks a defense position monster this turn, inflict piercing damage to your opponent, which is just really good because you can give it your opponent, you can give your monster piercing damage and double damage, which is just really awesome. And with the effect of Equalmax, he's going to gain the attack of both your Leonis and your Maximus, which is going to give him a grand total boost of 2800, putting him at 4800 attack points and double damage and piercing, which is just amazing. Like, this is my favorite kind of deck. Just a one-shot glass... I mean, it's not a glass cannon, because this deck actually protects itself quite well, but a one-shot, you know, OTK deck. And that's what this deck is based around. And you guys will see a lot of that on my channel. I've actually thought about mixing this with Shadowlands as well, because of all the different attributes. I might actually do that soon. Then I play three copies of the Water Crusadia. Her effect is not as great. If a Crusadia monster you control would be destroyed by battle or by card effect, you can banish this card from your field or grave instead. I just kind of use her for the Link plays. I don't usually summon her as my, you know, I'm going to go after my opponent for the kill move. I just usually do this as my, you know, summon this and then go into like Maxim or go into my Magius or my Regulex as my Link play. I'll go into those first and I'll use her for that ability. The next one that I play is three copies of Crusadia Draco. Crusadia Draco is extremely important to the combos that you summon your Crusadia Equalmax with. His effect is that if he's special summoned to his own Link monster points to you, you can target one Crusadia monster in your grave and add it back to your hand, which is extremely important to your plays to be able to recycle your Crusadia monsters and go into more plays. Then I play three copies for the final Crusadia monster of the main deck is three copies of Crusadia Reclusia. Crusadia Reclusia is... you can special summon it like all the other ones, but it also is kind of like Scrap Dragon. You can destroy one Crusadia card you control and one card your opponent controls. Which is really cool to be able to just Scrap Dragon your opponent with just a special summon monster. Then I play one copy of World Legacy World Crown because this deck is the king, and it deserves a crown. But basically, you can special summon this card from your hand in defense position to a zone a Link monster points to. That's the big thing that I use this for. Just to give me like an extra special summon. It has basically the same effect as all the Crusadia monsters. Then I play three copies of Rescue Cat. You use this to summon out Leonis and our Elephon. We use this and a Leonis to synchro summon into our Naturia Beast. And that's extremely easy to go into and make so many plays with. So that's it for the like main deck monsters. I'm going to show you a little side engine that I play as well right after I move these. So let me move these really quick and I'll show you that. It's really, really awesome. So the way that you OTK your opponent the majority of the time is with this particular engine, and that is a Kaiju engine, which I'm actually playing quite a few Kaijus in this deck. I am playing six different Kaijus in the deck. You can play any Kaiju you want as long as you play the Star Destroying Kaiju and the Lightning Strike Kaiju. These are the most important ones because what you'll essentially do is interrupt a Kaiju Slumber your opponent, summon this into the zone that you know you're going to summon your Equal Max over like this. And then give yourself, like, for instance, my big play is to summon it like this, and you get to decide where your opponent's Kaiju goes. So I always summon it right above, like this, above my opponent's, monster. So then my Crusadia Equimax is going to do double damage with Maximus. It's going to gain 33, 66, and then 1600 more, which brings him up to a grand total. I believe, if my math is correct, it would bring him up to 66 plus 16 would be 71 or 72, 80. He would be at 10,200. He'd be at 10,200 with double damage. You swing into the Kaiju and you instantly win just about any duel in case your opponent, unless your opponent's doing something crazy and gained a whole bunch of life points. This is like one of the only decks that can go up against Grand Majin with all that attack gains and still come out on top. So you play the Kaiju engine in here. It's extremely important to play to be able to summon it. And with our new card that we just got back, which is Interrupted Kaiju Slumber, that just came off the ban list and went to three, it just made the deck so much more powerful. Which we do play three copies of our Interrupted Kaiju Slumber as well. This leg is extremely important to be able to play in this deck. So that's it for the monsters, guys. Let's get into the spells. So for the spells, we're going to be playing three that I've already shown you. And that's three copies of Interrupted Kaiju Slumber, one copy of World Legacy Succession. World Legacy Succession lets you target a monster in your grave and special summon it to a zone a link monster points to, which is extremely important for this deck. To be able to just summon a monster right back from the grave. Three copies of Instant Fusion. This card gets cards off of your opponent's field by summoning Thousand Eyes Restrict, and being able to just gobble them up is really important in this deck to be able to just get cards, problematic cards, and summon Linkery Bow as well. The next one that I play is three copies of Call by the Grave. Call by the Grave is really important in the deck as well, because you don't want to get hand trapped in this deck, because you want to be able to just go off with your plays and OTK your opponent as quickly as possible. The next one I play is two copies of Crusadia Power. Crusadia Power's effect is that you get to target a Crusadia monster you control and make it unaffected by card effects this turn, which is except its own, which is really cool and just, you know, protects your Equal Max from just about everything. One copy of Crusadia Revival. The big thing about this is it lets you attack all monsters you want to control. So if you don't establish that Kaiju field, you can actually just make Equal Max have double damage and just swing it into everything with piercing as well. So it's extremely easy to establish that board. In this deck, it's very, very, very consistent to be able to summon that. So that's it for the spells, guys. And plus, it lets you gain 500 attack as well, which is kind of good, but kind of not needed. So the last card that we play in the main deck is one copy of Crusadia Vanguard. I don't use it all that often, but its effect is that when you activate this card, you can tribute a Crusadia or World Legacy monster, and if you do, special summon another Crusadia or World Legacy monster with a different original name from the deck or graveyard. And while you control a Crusadia Link monster, your opponent can only target Link monsters for attacks. But it's not that big of a deal because usually you're going to OTK your opponent anyways. So this is just kind of, if my opponent prevents my OTK, I'm going to use this to get the exact piece I need to help me for the next turn and set up. So that's it for the main deck, guys. Let's get into the extra deck. And if you guys already have not subscribed to Team FTK, I do encourage you guys to totally do that. now. So we play two copies of Crusadia Equal Max. Crusadia Equal Max gains attack for each monster that it points to, which is really cool. Like I said, that big play that I showed you before is about as big as you can get him to be, is 10,200 with piercing or with double damage, which just instantly OTKs your opponent. It's just absolutely nuts. And it also, it doesn't just stop there. You contribute a Crusadia monster or World Legacy monster that this card points to, then you get to target a face-up card your opponent controls, negate the effect until the end phase of the turn. So it's just really, really good to be able to have some preventative measures as well. And that is a quick effect too, which is just crazy. I play three copies of Regulex as well. You usually use this to rank up. It's kind of like ranking up or linking up into your Equal Max. This searches the spells. This one searches the spells, and then Magius searches the monsters. So the big play is to make Magius search a monster, special summon it, link it away, summon a Regulex, search the field spell, and then after you search the field spell, special summon another Crusadia, because you're going to open more than one Crusadia. And then summon Equal Max, which is extremely easy to do. I play one copy of Spatha. Usually I don't summon Spatha all that much, but she's there if I need to. Boral Sword Dragon. This is actually a proxy, guys. And for you guys who don't always watch my channel that are fans of FTK but have not found my channel yet, I actually have a video to show you guys how to make these particular proxies. They're really interesting proxies to be able to use on your cards if you're going to deck profile. If you guys are like new Yu-Gi-Tubers, or you just can't afford a Boral Sword Dragon and you want to play test with it with your friends, or if your friend can't and you want to give them a proxy so they can actually duel to their maximum potential. So this is just a way that you can actually make a card without having to spend $90 on it. I think actually Boral Sword is like 90 bucks right now. But then we play one copy of Linkaribo. We use this to link away for our Thousand Eyes Restrict, which I play two copies of Thousand Eyes Restrict because of the instant fusions that we play in this deck. It makes it really easy to steal our opponent's monsters and then Linkaribo into, you know, being able to just summon Linkaribo and, you know, stop our opponent. One copy of Breaksword. The occasional time I'll make Breaksword. It's very rare, but it's there if I need it. And then one copy of Naturibis to prevent my opponent's spells. So that's it for the deck profile, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this deck profile. If you guys have not already subscribed to Team FTK, be sure to hit that subscribe button right down there, and hit the bell. And if you guys really would, I'd really appreciate if you guys have not viewed my channel, which is Dark Arm Duelist. It will be down in the description down below, right down there. And guys, I will see you in the next video. It has been an honor, and thank you, FTK, for allowing me this opportunity to upload a video on your channel. I really appreciate what you're doing, and I really cannot wait to see you reach new heights. So, guys, I'll see you in the next video. See you around, guys.